Rev up your engines! Today I'm going to explain why almost all modern cars no longer have solid frames that they're built upon. Now originally, cars had solid steel frames that were either bolted or all welded together, then the body of the car bolted onto the frame. This way of making cars was called body on frame. There was a separate frame that the body was bolted to. But almost all cars today have what's called unibody construction, where the body and the frame is all one integral part. There is no separate frame. Now this isn't a new design. In 1915, the Ruler Motor Company of Illinois made a unibody car. It was called the Ruler Famous. But most cars back then, hey, they had solid frames and the bodies were bolted on the frames. There were two main reasons for that. First, if you have a solid steel frame, the vehicle is much more resistant to bending and any torsional forces when it either has heavy loads or is taking hard turns. The frames would keep things from twisting. Today, hey, big trucks like F-150s, they still have solid steel frames, actual frames. And the second reason is this. Even back in the day, people wanted different styles of cars. They're always changing the styles. And they found that if they made a solid frame, they can bolt any body style on top of it. So if they change the model, they can keep the same frame and just change the bodywork and bolt different bodywork on. Even in modern times, I was reading about the hydrogen cars and people were saying, oh, well, people aren't going to buy hydrogen cars because they cost too much money to produce and people don't want to spend that much money on a car. They'll get bored with how it looks. But one of their ideas with a hydrogen car is build them on solid frames. Then they can change the bodywork anytime they want. So, hey, if you're paying $100,000 for a car, you could drive it for 30 years. Just whenever you wanted, you could put different body panels on it to make it look differently. So a vehicle with actual frames, body on frame construction, have some big advantages, but they also have disadvantages. They cost more money to manufacture. If lately you've priced any full-size pickups, you'll see what I'm talking about. Some of those things are over $50,000. And alas, the steel frame with the body bolted on, they weigh more. So they're gonna get worse gas mileage. And gas mileage is a big thing these days. So being cheaper to make, weighing less, unibody construction, hey, it's taken over the vast majority of vehicles these days, other than large trucks. Heck, in 1984, the Jeep Cherokee was the first SUV type vehicle made that didn't have a big frame on it anymore. It was unibody too, even back in 1984. And in 1994, the Toyota RAV4 was the first real mass produced SUV or crossover vehicle that didn't have a frame on it that was all unibody construction. Now almost all of them are unibody construction. Now unibody construction does have its benefits. It's cheaper to make, lighter weight, so it gets better gas mileage. And here's a strange fact. Unibody construction is actually safer for you, the occupants, although it's less safe for the vehicle itself. Since it's a lighter construction method, the crumple zones are everywhere. When you get in a wreck, all that energy has to go somewhere. If that energy goes to crumple all the pieces of the cars in, it can dissipate more of the energy, so you as the occupant don't get smashed around as much. A solid frame vehicle, that frame is real tough. It's going to resist being crumpled, so that power's got to go somewhere and it'll go to jolting you around inside the car or making you hit the windshield. So ultimately, unibody cars are safer. They do much better in those crash tests. When you see those crash test dummy tests that they have, hey, you see the cars all crumple up with a unibody. The frame ones won't do that. I've seen that personally. My kids were on a school bus one time that got in a wreck. So I went to get them, and there's the school bus. You could barely tell anything had happened to the school bus, but it had run into a SUV. And the SUV was totally crumpled and it was destroyed. So the school bus, hey, it was saved. The kids were okay too because they weren't going all that fast and being that high up in the air. And since the school bus has the vast amount of energy, it's taking its energy going to the SUV. The SUV energy didn't do much to the bus. But the passengers in the SUV, hey, they were all okay, even though their car was destroyed. and was totaled. And as I said, the frames are more resistant to any type of torsional effects when you're either carrying loads or cornering hard, but engineers have figured ways to make the unibody constructions handle quite well. As you can see on this Lexus, it's got a bar the whole way across the front that keeps it from getting body torsions when you corner hard. There's ways to make them ride quite well. Of course, they can't handle big weight like a big F-150 truck, which still has a solid steel frame around, but hey, you're not carrying rocks around in your Lexus. A lot of old timers, they say, hey, I want a car with a solid frame and this and that, but really, with the comfort and drivability of unibody construction, plus the ability to save people in crashes and get better gas mileage, they're not gonna come back with body on frames anytime soon. And if you really think about it, if you get in a big wreck, what would you rather have survive? Yourself or your car? And since this is the Thursday segment where I answer a viewer's question, place your own question on the YouTube comments below and I'll pick the best ones to make a single video to answer your questions. So where else can you find a guy with 50 years experience of fixing cars to answer your own question with a video? So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.